The lightning again!
The lightning again!
Go leave.
Let's go!
Give me what I want!
Kick down the door!
Drew, you are not doing this!
What the?
Not nice!
There's a giant head!
You hear yourself?
I made like 2,000 of these. I'd like to have fun.
With you wherever you are, welcome to LFR.
Victory, Puppy Ziggy! Here we go again! Here we go again! Here we go again! Here we go again!
For the last time this regular season, Leafs win! 4-3 over the New York Rangers in a game that super didn't matter until it super did. And you never know. So think you know which way it's gonna go? I did. I bet $1. That's how little this game mattered. $2 Steve went down to $1. And I did that at Sports Interaction. Because when the puck drops, Sports Interaction has you covered. Pre-game live betting on all major sports. You can't bet on the Raptors anymore because they got eliminated. And prospects? Prop bets. Words are hard. Want to bet? Head to sportsinteraction.com/SDPN and download the Sports Interaction app, but only if you're 19 plus, you silly goose. Please play responsibly. Dude, I am tempted to skip to the third period to start this video. I'm serious. And it's not because of laziness on my part or a lack of effort. Look at this! Look! You can even tell by the shots on goal no one was trying! That was a public skate! A 40-minute public skate. Dude, that was 40 minutes of no one trying but William Nylander, who didn't score until everyone started trying. The shots were 7-5 for Toronto in the first period. There weren't any goals. The shots were 7-5 for the Rangers in the second period. There was one goal, Kaapo Kakko. It was kind of nice. And that was it. Shots 12-12 after 40. Neither team was on pace for 20 shots in the game. That's true. I did the math. After the second period, shots on goal were on pace to be 18 apiece. That would have been low in the dead puck era. So the third period comes. The Leafs have not been shut out yet this season, and oh, wouldn't it just be perfect to ruin all that in game 82? That would be so Leafs! Until 3 minutes into the third period, here comes Timothy Liljegren with a blistering shot! Off topic, I'm pretty sure this is signed by Luke Shen. Either him or Ron Hainsey. It looks like a Luke Shen signature. I was given this like 4 years ago. I don't know either. Relevant again, though. Anyway, the Leafs tied off a trickling fart of a shot from Timothy Liljegren that obviously got deflected. That's why it fooled Yaroslav Halak so badly. And it's tied. By golly, it's tied. All it guarantees is they don't get shut out. And here's the thing. There's only been two goals in this game. But the first one from the Rangers, you wonder, could they challenge for goalie interference? There was a Ranger kind of all up in Wool's grill, and did Panarin kick the glove? I don't know. But it's game 82. It's game 82. Stop. No. But once it was 1-1 in the third period, and both teams decided, well, we're here, and there seems to be quite a few people here, and what's the name of this building again? Madison Square Garden? Oh, I gotta take some pictures before I leave. Once that happened, the video coach was like, we should challenge some stuff. And the Rangers score a goal, and it's a nice goal. Braden Schneider's first in over 40 games, and it's offside. And they review it, and it's a quick review. That's how you know it was offside. No goal. And that's when both teams were, like, starting to try. And it's like, after the Leafs challenged that, the Rangers were like, yeah? Oh yeah, okay! Luke Shen takes a penalty, and you could tell the Rangers took it personally with the way they played that power play. The Leafs hadn't allowed a power play goal in so long. Thanks, Gord Miller and Mike Johnston, by the way. You screwed that up pretty good, jinxing it on TV! And the Rangers score, Artemi Panarin, his 29th. Less than a minute and a half later, in comes William Nylander, in comes his 40th goal of the season! We might as well play while we're here! And a little under 5 minutes later, someone who did not get the memo that no one was trying? Noel Achari. William Nylander was trying to hit 40 goals. What was Noel Achari trying to do? He was sitting on 13 goals. His career high was 20. He wasn't gonna hit that. Career high was 27 points. He was sitting on 22. Well, I suppose he could have hit that. Like, that dude missed a couple hits that I think his body, halfway, three quarters of the way through the hit, was like, wait, no. Even Luke Shen threw one where I'm like, Luke, Simmer down. Save it. Hits were 14 to 10 for the Leafs, by the way, in case you were wondering. Blocks were 17 to 11 for the Rangers. What? Why was it even that high? You guys both have something to do next week. But William Nylander scores to tie it. Noel Acciari scores. And big Selly from the guy. He might like hockey a little bit. Noel Acciari can't not. He can't not. Some guys can't. He can't not. We all said no one's going to try tonight. Noel Acciari said, I can't not. He scores. Big Selly. The Leafs have the lead. The Rangers get a power play late and pull the goalie because, again, we're all here and screw it. 5, 4, 3, 2. You're joking me. Game 82. We're really going to do this? Really? But wait. Maybe I want them to do this because Mitch Marner, he's still sitting on 99 points. And he tried for the empty net, it's blocked. Because again, the Rangers are like, we might as well do this. Tries again, it's blocked. We might as well do this. And the Rangers tie it with a second to play because we might as well do this. And Sheldon Keefe said, review it because we might as well do this. Dude, I know it sucks to have two goals called back in the same game, but like, whereas the New Jersey Devils with their three called back in one game, a couple of those were maybe sort of borderline. Neither of these were close. The offside was so offside. The Heedle kick was very definitely a kick. In a league where I cannot tell you exactly what a kick is, that was for sure a kick. Which means the Leafs win! Which means there's no overtime! Which means Mitch Marner does not get another opportunity to hit 100. He ends the season with 99 points. Questions, and I think this one's valid. From Tim, two questions, but I think they're related. Do you think it was a mistake to keep Marner out against Tampa or Detroit? And will the Leafs ask for a review of the disallowed assist against Florida? Okay, so producer Drew and I had a disagreement about this. There was an Austin Matthews goal in that Florida game two games before this one, where Matthews scored off a pass from Mitch Marner, but it hit a Florida defender's skate before hitting Matthews' stick. I don't think it was intentionally booted towards Matthews. I think the puck got there because of Mitch. Give Mitch the assist. That should have been an assist! Even if you don't think it should have been, there have been dumber assists. Goalie touches the thing behind the net, leaves it for a defender who takes it all the way up the ice, passes to a guy in front, and he scores. Remember when Jack Campbell did that last year? That was hilarious. But that was a Leaf doing it, so it's fine. IMO, IMHO, dude, Mitch got robbed. But, this team will not be defined or even remembered for the amount of points they get in a regular season. You know what? I hope people remember that Mitch Marner was this Leafs team's MVP all regular season long. But no. We're done with all that. How many goals did John Tavares have his first season as a Leaf? Some of you might know. Some of you hardcores might know. But it doesn't matter. How many points did Mitch Marner have as a rookie? You might know. It doesn't matter. How many points did he have last year? You might know. It doesn't matter. Matthews, 60 goals. That's the free space. But did you feel great about the 60 goals when it happened? Of course you did. Did you feel great about it after Tampa? No, you didn't. Did you win? That's all anyone remembers. And isn't this the question from Paul? A 50-win season. Should that be enough for MLSE brass to hurry up and make their biggest extension in Kyle Dubas? Or should his faith be tied to whatever happens in the next few weeks? Okay, I'm about to say two sentences that make complete sense. You can't let go of a GM who has had multiple 100-point seasons with his team and is coming off of a 50-win season with his team. All right, there's one sentence. You cannot re-sign a GM who has had 5 consecutive first-round losses, and you might not even consider one of them a first-round loss because it was a qualifying round loss. They invented a playoff round to play in, and they still lost in it! The question of what happens to Kyle Dubas is totally fascinating. And there isn't an objectively right answer. There isn't. There is not. They're a fantastic regular season team. I'm not even convinced they're a bad playoff team or have been a bad playoff team. Steve, they haven't even won a round. They were right there every time. The only one you can call a certifiable joke is, well, 2013. Kyle doesn't have to answer for that. But under Kyle Dubas was the Montreal one. And even that! The captain! The argument that the team, oh, well, they're not built for playoff hockey. Even that is not true. Look at this year's team. Look at it objectively. What are you going to say? They can't score? Yes, they can. Goaltending? Not elite, but good. Good! Especially considering the circumstances. Good! Toughness? Oh, they're not tough. Have you been watching? Yes, they are! This is easily the toughest Leaf team they've iced in how long? How long? Since 2013? And they got a lot more skill than that team. Easily. And their defense. Oh, what about their defense? It's not top five, but it's good. It's not going to cost them. It's good. There is no good reason to bet against the Leafs. There is no good argument to bet against this Leafs team other than that there's two. Meh, Tampa. And my Leafs. No other team in the league is in this position. You know that, right? Like, there, you look at every other series, and there are favorites, and there are teams that are underdogs, and there are arguments for why the underdog should be the favorite, and why the favorite should be the underdog, and they're all legitimate reasons, and it's great discourse and whatever. And with the Leafs, it's like, well, they're clearly the favored team on paper, but have you considered the worst might happen for no good reason? And for any other team in the league, that would be an unreasonable thing to say, but it's the Leafs. So getting away from what you asked there, Paul, I don't know. It's right now, today, which is probably the most rational we're going to be for like a while. It doesn't make any sense to not bring back Kyle Dubas. If they lose in the first round, we're going to feel different. We'll force ourselves to say the opposite of that. No, even though this happened, no. You're in your heart, you will feel different. I don't know what the right answer is. I tell you what, I hope we never have to answer that question. We never have to answer that question if the Leafs win a round and maybe win two, three, or four. Please. Please! Well, that's it. Feels weird. There's not going to be a Leaf game for a few days. We're going to come back. And we'll see what we have to say. Maybe a series preview at some point. I think we're doing that for SDPN, actually. Once again, the Leafs are in a playoff spot. They're in a playoff series. They have home ice advantage for the third straight series. And we'll just have to see what happens. That is it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Click like if you like this video. Click subscribe if you really liked it. Tell all your friends. I noticed something today, and that is my nails are a little bit longer than they usually are at this time of year because I'm not scared. I'm not nervous. I am all in. Go, Leafs, go! Please!